Hey there guys, welcome to another episode. My name is Sparkman, I'm a game developer. Today we're going to create something like Last Stand. Okay, so if you open the example file, which you can find under the description below. If you run this, you notice that you can move your character up and down, and there will be zombies. If you press spacebar, you can shoot them. Shoot the zombies. Now this character here is a 8 direction object. I only enable up and down. My initial direction is left. Now so the character doesn't get out of the play area, I put these two invisible objects. Here is the zombie, here's the zombie animation. Now you can make animations like this very easy using Fusion Character Animator. Actually, I made a video how to use a Fusion Character Animator. This is from last year. That's the video there, and I sound horrible there. Not that I sound any better now.
To get out of the island,
there are the zombies.
To be able to catch the helicopter. Okay. Fusion Character Animator.
Whoa, I guess what he was gonna say. Okay, so I gotta turn it off because I can't listen to myself.
And Fusion Character Animator. Okay.
And, whoa, how do you guys watch this stuff? This stuff is boring.
There are different animations.
I'm falling asleep already.
Okay.
Here comes the upbeat music. Maybe I can make it less boring. It's actually pretty easy to use. Check it out. Okay, so we're back to the present again. As you can see, I used the time machine to go back in time. The tutorial for the time machine came out pretty handy. We're back to the present now. Check your clock on your computer. Okay, so here's the animation when the zombie's dying. Die, zombie. Here is the blood splattered animation, which is really not an animation, it's only like 4 frames. Here's the background. Here's my character. Here's the walking animation. I have 3 objects here so we can spawn the zombies. Right now the zombies only spawn at the blue box. We want our zombies to spawn randomly between these 3 positions. Okay, so to do that, I'm going to clone this counter. And let's place it over here. It doesn't really matter where. Discounter green. Okay, it's green now. You could probably call it R&D as random. Let's go to the event editor. And I'm gonna put all this into a group. Cut all this. Call the group stuff. Paste all the events there and I can collapse them. So we're gonna start at line 13. We're gonna use the timer. Every millisecond, we're going to set our green counter randomly, random range between 0 and 2. I go to, okay, so let's collapse this and let's find the part where we create the zombie, which is line 9. I'm going to cut that, collapse this, paste it on line 13. So we're creating a zombie randomly between 2 seconds and 2.4 seconds if the number of zombies is less than 3. Let's create another condition. This counter needs to be 0. You can see that we're creating the zombie at the blue box. Copy line 13, paste it. Let's change the number for 1 and let's change the position to the red box. Copy, paste, change the number to 2, and we're going to change the position to the yellow box. We actually don't need to add anything to this counter. Okay, so let's try it out. You can see our counter fluctuating between 0 and 2 and 1. There come the zombies. Let's shoot them, because that's what you do. Zombies were made to shoot in video games. Now, a game like this is probably more suited for cell phones and tablets. If you like this video, hit the like button. And if you didn't like the video, smack the dislike button. And now it's time for the first and top comment.
I know it's been about like 55 years since I uploaded my last YouTube video.
Alright, so thanks for watching. Follow me on Twitter. My Twitter account is SparkmanX. Sparkman was taken already for some reason by some guy named Jose. If you got any tutorial requests, you can leave it down in the comment below. You can also check out my forum. I have a tutorial request board. Okay, so follow me on Twitter, and I will see you in the next episode. Bye now.